Now, an Eyewitness News exclusive historic catch. A milestone moment at sea involving the top predator on the food chain.
Come on, George.
We were the only news team there when this great white shark was caught, tagged, and released. It's the species' first male ever tagged in the North Atlantic.
The research group that did it, OSearch, named him George after the expedition leader's father. He could be a key piece to the puzzle about how to bring the shark population back.
And we found out that helping the missing predator may make economic sense because of the impact it's having on a sea creature with a much friendlier image than the great white. Walt Buteau has the exclusive video and details from off the coast of Nantucket.
They've been trying for years, but a male great white shark had never been tagged in the North Atlantic until now. It was slack tide, 15 miles off Nantucket, in about 23 feet of water.
And then boom, we got eaten.
The fishing team that's tagged dozens of female great whites since 2012 knew something was different as soon as this shark took the bait.
And it was on hard and fast, and that's really different than the females. They're much more deliberate. Sometimes we'll play cat and mouse with them for a couple hours before that they'll actually pick up a bait, and this thing just came in hot.
The 10-foot, 700-pounder was then guided through the water for about 20 minutes to calm it down. Then onto the OSearch platform, where the crew surrounded the great white and worked quickly. Fins swabbed for parasites, vital signs recorded, blood samples taken.
Okay, I have it.
And tested in the onboard lab. Blood work determined that despite the struggle on the hook and on the platform,
come on, George,
there were no chemical signs of harmful physical stress.
That's really important because you put all those tags, you want that shark to swim off really healthy to give us years of information and data.
Okay, we're gonna name the shark.
The key finding of this expedition was more obvious. The shark was a male. Expedition leader Chris Fisher teared up as he decided to name the shark George after a key OSearch supporter.
A male! Oh my God! I'd been trying to name a mature male white shark after my father since 2012.
Oh, there we go.
As George is tracked, with three devices, including one on his dorsal fin, the information will be used to help this species survive.
The males and the females don't live together. So when you can track a mature male, overlap it with the tracks of mature females, where they cross over, that's your first shot at actually proving there's a mating site.
The fear of the fin is overblown, according to Fisher, who says the more important concern should be the shark's impact on the food chain. He tells us the creatures that a healthy great white population would control are taking a bite out of the catch the fishing industry is trying to net. Among the sharks prey that some are calling a pest is the gray seal. This video was shot on an island off Nantucket where one organization claims the mammal's comeback now totals between 10 and 30,000 seals. Commercial fishermen say they're eating their livelihood.
To the point.
This clip shows a seal taking a shoreline fisherman's catch.
But certainly soon the data will say we got to do something about the seals. So will we have the kind of mental discipline to overcome emotion? Those are the kind of questions that are really going to need to be answered before we figure out how to handle the seals.
After about an hour in captivity, the first male was off, unknowingly a piece of a much bigger picture. Putting that puzzle together may still be years away, so the work out here continues. Off the coast of Nantucket, Walt Buteau, Eyewitness News.
Some incredible video there, and it is going to take decades for the shark population to increase to a level that'll help decrease the current abundance of seals.
And new at 6, why the law that protects seals may be outdated.
Now, an Eyewitness News exclusive historic catch. We were there as the first male great white shark was tagged in the North Atlantic.
His name is George. It's in honor of the father of the expedition's leader. And this 700-pounder may lead the crew to a great white mating site.
We found that one of the reasons to restore the shark population is to help the food chain. That's important to both the fishing industry and consumers.
And one piece of that puzzle is the abundant seal population. New at 6, why the law that protects seals may be outdated. Walt Buteau has the exclusive story.
A record number of harbor seals were counted in Narragansett Bay this year, but the gray seal population may be growing even faster. We found that out while searching for sharks off the coast of Nantucket.
First, the catch that's been anticipated by O-Search for about 5 years.
George,
the only male great white ever snagged and tagged in the North Atlantic.
A male. Oh, my God.
A short time later, the hook barely wet, and a second great white is on the line. This one is a female that would be named Yeti. She's guided onto the platform, and with three tracking devices attached,
get her done, Yeti.
She was released, joining George and dozens of other great whites now being tracked and researched around the world. Captain Brett McBride is the man on the platform who steers the giants back to freedom.
I'm in a position where I can do my little part to give back. So that's how I look at it when this is all going on. It's really not a big adrenaline rush or anything. It's mostly I have a lot of weight on my shoulders to make sure it all goes smooth and the shark gets let go alive and healthy.
O-Search is collecting data to help restore the great white population. They believe the food chain will be healthier with the shark-controlling species that consume the fish humans catch and eat. Among the shark's prey that some believe are out of control is the seal.
So as the white shark recovers, it will impact the behavior of the seal, and it will help the seal numbers. But you're going to see seal numbers rise from here all the way down through the eastern seaboard because their historic range is much, much bigger than it is. It's just now recovering.
Crocker Snow is among the members of the Seal Abatement Coalition, also known as SAC. He points to Muskeget Island, only miles from where George and Yeti were caught. SAC says this and other areas are overrun by gray seals. Commercial fishing crews claim the mammals that weigh up to 700 pounds are depleting their catch. Even shore fishermen are competing with the seals, who are seen bursting out of the water to take fish right off their hooks. Another concern is disease. Snow says 1 in 5 baby seals is infected with avian flu from drinking the water on Muskeget Island.
To find traces of avian flu in 20% or more of the Muskeget pups is something that people at MIT, people at Woods Hole and other places are more and more concerned about.
The seal is currently guarded by the Marine Mammal Protection Act. SAC is pushing for at least a dialogue about how to manage this booming population.
A symposium on the seal population is scheduled for next month in Nantucket. While the seal population appears to be growing, we're told it could be years before the shark population is back to where O-Search thinks it should be. Walt Buteau, Eyewitness News.
And our coverage continues right now on our website. Go to WPRI.com to see where George and Yeti are right now.
That's right. We have a link to O-Search's Global Shark Tracker. It maps out all of the tagged sharks' travels.